This morning on The Dish, Chef Matt McClure, born and raised in Arkansas. He loved hunting, fishing, and his grandmother's cooking. His passion for food sent him way up north, though, to the New England Culinary Institute in Vermont, and then jobs at some of the top restaurants in Boston.
Fulfilling a dream to return to his home state, he first worked in his native Little Rock, and then in 2012, he helped open The Hive in Bentonville, Arkansas. It's high South cuisine, as it's described, based on local ingredients and traditional methods, and it earned him a 2015 Food and Wine Award as the people's best new chef for the region. And Chef Matt McClure, good morning.
Good morning.
To The Dish. Can you start off by giving us a sense of what we have here before we dive in?
Sure, yes. So this is kind of a great example of the way I like to cook, specifically, you know, in Bentonville at The Hive. So taking sort of recognizable ingredients and then just sort of like dressing them up and getting sort of inspiration from the local immigrant communities that are part of Northwest Arkansas.
Amazing. So, chicken and corn.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, it's, you know, some of my favorite foods. So chicken, this is just a roasted chicken. Sort of spiced with garam masala. It's just this great Indian spice mix. We've got the tomatoes and peaches. You know, writing a menu for being in the summer is super easy because we have so much great produce coming out of the farmers markets to work with. So we got these great peaches, tomatoes, cream corn with like a chili butter, and then some cured bacon in there. You can't leave out the pimento cheese and bacon jam.
Oh, cuisine, part of every fine dining experience, pimento cheese.
A great, what's our cocktail that we've got going on?
So the cocktail is, it's a peach and peach and basil shrub. So it's kind of a classic way I like to make a cocktail. Super refreshing. Jazzed
really
up with bourbon.
Yeah,
very acidic, so it's light and flavorful. And
Matt, it's sort of interesting. I mean, as we eat this cuisine, this is your what you're doing now, but you went up to Boston and to, I guess, New England, really. What did you learn in Boston that sort of has helped shape you into the chef that you are?
It's so much about food. I learned the techniques, sort of respect for ingredients, how to be a leader in the kitchen, creativity, and then, you know, sort of coming back to Arkansas, realizing that all of these foods, the growing season's much longer in Arkansas than it is in Boston. So I have access to a lot more locally grown food throughout the year. And that was just very exciting for me, sort of, you know, bringing all that I had learned back to Arkansas.
It wasn't a direct path to Vermont and then to Boston. You started out, I think, going to become a mechanical engineer.
Yeah. Who knows
quite
what
a left turn.
Yeah. Who knows what they want to do when they're 18, right? I was. I went to the University of Arkansas. I thought I was going to be a mechanical engineer, and one of my professors told me that he had almost gone to culinary school. It wasn't something that I thought that was a career path for me, but it sounded great. And next thing you know, I'm moving to Vermont.
Now back in Arkansas, where you are with The Hive, you've said that The Hive is sort of your story. This is the restaurant that you have now. How is that your story and the food that we're eating?
Yeah, so the menu is, you know, kind of my story. It's foods that that I guess through my path. So, you know, something as simple as roasted chicken. It's probably one of my favorite things to eat. I think it's very underrated. But, you know, moving to Boston and, you know, seeing how they drew inspiration from a lot of the immigrant populations in that city, you know, I sort of apply the same thing. And so when I go to Northwest Arkansas, I look around, I see what are the raw materials I have to work with, you know, what is Arkansas food in general, and I think this is kind of a snapshot of what it is.
A delicious one.
Yeah, a fantastic one. Well, as I give you The Dish on The Dish to sign, I'll ask you if you could have a meal with anyone, past or present, who would it be?
I would definitely be my ancestors, grandparents, great-grandparents, but also my wife and daughter, and I've got a son on the way, so.
Congratulations.
Be a big family gathering.
Well, Chef Matt McClure, thank you so much. And for more on Chef McClure and The Dish, you can head to our website at cbsthismorning.com.